Hey guys, this is Romnick Regalario, and if you're a student or new in sterile processing, stay for the whole video because it might help you with your career. Okay guys, let's get on it, okay? So first things first, if you're going to be working as a sterile processing, you got to have your own working shoes. So these shoes will stay at work, do not take it home. So you're gonna have two shoes, so one specifically only for working, which you will keep at work, and then one that you will take home. So these working shoes has to stay either in your locker or anywhere in the hospital or anywhere in your department where you can keep it. Do not try to take it home, because you don't know how dirty it will be once you start working in cell processing, especially if you are working in the decon. And you know, if you're new, most likely you will be working in the decon. It's either if you're a new technician, or if you're from agency, or if you're a student, you will definitely go to decon. So have working shoes, a good shoes for long day standing, and make sure it has enough protection for your feet, just in case some chemicals or dirty water get your shoes wet. And plus, whenever you're gonna be working in the decon, you can always cover your shoes. And once you leave decon, then you take it off, and then you can continue working in the sterile processing. Next, let's talk about what to wear to work. Personally, I like to wear something loose, something easy to remove, and something easy to put on. Because when you get to your department, you're gonna be wearing scrubs, and do not try to take it home and do the laundry yourself. And because that would be against the rules, and plus you don't know how dirty it is, so you don't really want to take it home. Every day you have your new scrubs anyway, so you don't have to worry about it. I'm telling you this because I know some people that does this, and we are not supposed to. And now let's talk about PPE before going into the decon. So let's start with a shoe cover. When you go to the decon and you're going to be working in the decon, make sure you have a shoe cover. It's to protect your shoes from getting wet or getting soiled, and it's best for you also to protect your feet, just in case chemicals get spilled on it. It's an extra layer of protection that you want to have to protect yourself. Next is the gown. So there's actually three kinds of gown that you could encounter. So one reusable gown and two disposable gowns. So the reusable one, I personally don't like them. And the second one is the non-woven disposable gown. I don't like them either. And the third one is the plastic gown. That's the one I prefer. You know why? Because plastic, the water doesn't go through it. The cons on that one though, it's easily to get ripped, and you can get sweaty from it. But then you can rest assured that the water won't penetrate. Unlike the non-woven one, sometimes water do penetrate, and same thing with the reusable one. Next is the mask. So in the decon, there's maybe two kinds of masks you could use. There's a mask that also with a face shield. If you want to use that, some people prefer that. I personally don't, because that one gets foggy so quick. So the way I want it is the regular mask. I don't like the mask with the loop, with the, you know, the elastic loop. I'd rather have the one that you tie on behind of your neck, because that way you could adjust it. So I personally like the regular mask plus the full face shield, not the one combined together. So regular mask and the full face shield, that's the one that I like better. The next one is the gloves. So there's two kind of gloves that I've seen. So one is the thick one, which is the chemo gloves, I think that's what they call it, and the one that goes up over here, the long sleeve gloves. I prefer the chemo one because it's thicker, unlike the long sleeve one, which is a little bit thinner. Some people like the long sleeve one because it could protect you up all the way up here, but what I usually do is, before I put my gown on, regular gloves, regular thick gloves, gown on, and then the chemo gloves on top of it. So that way, because sometimes whichever gloves you use, there's still a tendency that they'll get puncture. But if you have that metal layer, it will protect your hand to get wet from the soiled water. Soiled water and the chemical as well. So if you want to do that too, just another extra thing you could do to protect yourself. But that's totally up to you though. So different hospitals have different policy and procedures when it comes to use surgical instruments. Regarding the cards, the case cards, make sure you check if it's been sprayed with enzymatic solution. Because, you know, different facilities, it depends on the nurses or the surgical techs or whoever's working in the OR. Sometimes they don't have time or they forget. And you don't want the blood to get so dry because it's going to be so hard for you to clean them. So make sure if it's not sprayed with enzymatic solution, make sure you spray yourself. Make sure you spray the whole thing, especially the bloody parts, especially the orthos and laparoscopic instruments. Those are really hard to clean if the blood are already dry. You can also have the water running already for the sink and have your detergent ready. So that way, while you're spraying those blood, by the time you finish, your water on the sink is already ready for you when you start working on those cards. And if you have multiple cards, do not work on all cards at the same time. You have to do it one card at a time, okay? Because you don't want to mix all the instruments. It's going to be really hard for the people in the clean or assembly area if you have two sets of instruments mixed together, especially if two different surgeries. So make sure you work one card at a time and make sure you finish the whole card before you go to the next. If it's ortho instruments, that would be so bloody. So make sure you soak it a little bit, put it in the water with the detergent, soak it there a little bit, and then make sure you clean it manually. You have to make sure you're cleaning all of them one manually. Even though you have a washer disinfector, washer disinfector won't work if you don't do your job properly. So you have to make sure you do it properly manually before you even sending it to the washer disinfector. And if you're scanning with SPM, then make sure you scan it before you send it, okay? If you are working in the decon, you always have to protect yourself. Do not assume that because you have gloves on, you are totally protected. No, do not just dig in it. You have to do it slowly and carefully. Some sets have the needles in the set, forgotten by whoever's working in the OR. Needles is very sharp and it will penetrate on your gloves. And also the blades on the knife handles, especially the number three knife handles. I've seen it many times and I can totally be sure that it will penetrate your gloves because it's very sharp. If you're working with ortho or laparoscopic instruments, most likely you're going to be changing the water often. And also, if you're working with a string instrument, I make sure I put everything in a stringer. So in the decon, there's a stringer, the bigger stringer. So try to draw with the scissors. Next is the needle holders, then the clamps, and then whatever is the bigger instruments next to it. So if you do it that way, it will be so easy for the people in the assembly area to put it together. If you do it that way, I'm pretty sure they'll be happy that you are the one working in the decon. Decon and assembly, that's my favorite assignment. So I'm telling you now how it would help the people on the other side and how to help you be a better worker. Take note, make sure when you're working on ortho stuff, make sure you open those depth gauge and check those suctions. Make sure you flush them, and those laparoscopic, make sure you flush all of them and disassemble them prior to sending it to the decontaminator. And by the way guys, I know it's gonna be so hard if you're a student, and if you're a student, you have to give your best. And if you need help on how to give your best, send your email down, comment your email down, and we will talk. I offer a mentorship if you ever need it, and I'm pretty sure you will benefit from it absolutely. Okay guys, thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next video.